What do you think the definition of marriage is? Don't look to your paper. It's not like an exam thing. This is meant to take home. The paper to remind you, what the definition of marriage? If I ask you to define it, what is it? What is marriage? Huh?
A formal relationship.
What?
Formal relationship.
A formal relationship. What else?
Marriage is a contract where two people come together, but they, you know, they must have some love for each other.
It's a contract that brings two people together. They should have love within them.
You must have that love. Although love is something that grows, you know, but you must have that type of feelings or
connection. Okay. What is marriage? Again, it's good. All of you said it's correct, correct. What else? What marriage is? From Shari'i perspective. It's a contract, period. Huh? That is a strong word, oh, by the way. You know, sometimes the ability of defining things in one word, it become more complicated, of course, because you need to, you know, in the fiqh, when you study fiqh, you have matn. And then you have hashia, which is hashia is the commentary on the text. Then you have hashia al-hashia, which is a commentary on the commentary, sometimes because that's ulama used to write some difficult language. But it say is a contract. Yes. Marriage is a mutual contract and a pledge that a man and a woman entered into that contract with understanding to fulfill the condition of the contract based on the teaching of the Quran and the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The definition of it. And that's why Quran al-Kareem call it Mithaq Ghaliz. Mithaq Ghaliz, you know, strong covenant or pledge that husband and wife give to one another. وَكَيْفَ تَأْخُذُونَهُ وَقَدْ أَفْضَى بَعْضُكُمْ إِلَى بَعْضٍ وَأَخَذْنَا مِنْكُمْ مِثَاقًا غَلِيظًا. Quran al-Kareem says, how comes you take back the dowry that you have given after you have given the strong oath, pledge, in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, mithaq and ghaliza. Therefore, it is a mithaq ghaliz that you know, when people enter, and that people have to think it as such. You know, always I make this, it's funny, but it's sad. That people sometimes think marriage is drive-through thing. Las Vegas marriage. They get in the car and they call drive-through marriages. You know, people might sometimes call you, said, Brother Majid, would you like to get married? I said, when? They said, now. It's 10 o'clock at night. I said, Brother, wait until tomorrow morning. Brother, we cannot do that. We have to get married now. I said, why you cannot do that? How long, you know, been not married? Yeah, what happened now? Just this moment, 10 o'clock, Saturday night, you want to get married. And sometimes they used to tell me, Brother Majid, we want you to get, you know, have us to get married. And please don't say no, 10 o'clock. You know, I said, even if I want to marry you now, 10 o'clock, by the time I reach you, maybe 11 o'clock, I said, no, brother, we're in the parking lot of my apartment, when I used to live in an apartment. They come together in the car, want to get married. This fast food marriages is not going to work. People have to be serious about it. Have to know what it takes. It's not in and out, getting married and then get divorced. It have to, people think about it seriously. Therefore, this is my advice to young people. Therefore, marriage is that strong pledge that people give. When they say, I do, you said, I do, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have written that answer that you've given, that pledge you have given. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nisa, Ya ayyuha an-nas ittaqu rabbakum, all people, be conscious of your Lord. Alladhi khalaqakum min nafsin wahida, the one who created from one soul. Wa khalaqa minha zawjaha, and created from it its mates. Wa batha minhuma rijalan kathira wa nisa'a, and he from them, he have created many men and women, scattered men and women. رجال كثيرة ونساء. واتقوا الله, be aware, be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الذي تساءلون به. Underline this. In Arabic, means the one that you ask of your mutual rights in his name. تساءلون به. You ask for your mutual rights in his name. تساءلون به والأرحام. And your kinship. إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. Allah watch over you. Therefore, entering marriage contract with that understanding and reminding ourselves of that pledge, we should make a person what? Think 100 times before ending this relationship. Because it's a mithaq qalid people have given. Therefore, this is the, and you know what the word aqd is in Arabic? The word aqd. And that's why Arabic language sometimes very important, brothers and sisters, to understand this concept. The word aqd in Arabic. What is aqd? What is the Arabic linguistic meaning? Who's Arabic speaking here? Aqd. Uqda is the knot. The knot. But aqd is what? To tie. You call uqda al-nikah, the knot of the marriage. But in order for it, you have to, the process of it is the aqd. Then after the aqd finish, it become uqda. Uqda al-nikah, Quran says. Therefore, what you do in marriage, you tie. What happened when divorce take place? What the word talaq in Arabic, do you know? From talaqa, yatliqu, is to release. Talaq is to release the knot. And aqd is to tie. Therefore, when people get married, they have done this. Okay? Tied the knot. Yes?
Tying the knot.
What?
You know, in American culture, they say tying the knot.
Yeah, really? In marriage, they say that? Maybe they learned it from us. Okay? Therefore, tying the knot. This is the Arabic word of aqd. Therefore, think about your spouse. And you and your spouse as the knot. You've been tied. Then